Good morning and
good morning.
Welcome to everyone this morning. Great morning. To see you all this morning. Welcome you to Destiny Church here in the UK, and a big welcome to everyone around the world and across the UK. So it's good to have you with us. We're in the 10:50 club, so we've got around about 10 minutes before we go live with the countdown, and then we'll be into the worship and the message. So we're looking forward to a great time this morning, aren't we?
Yeah, we are. Yeah, it's been an amazing start to a new series. Win-win. I mean, what's not to like about that? And looking forward to everybody joining us as soon as they can, and that they put on their pictures and share us on Facebook, start up a watch party, and look forward to all that the Lord's doing for us. Yeah, we're just having such a nice time this morning. We've been quite relaxed this morning for a change.
Yeah, we have. We should say, I'm Paul and you're Liz. We should say that at the beginning, didn't we? Just don't want to assume that everyone knows us, do we? So, a big welcome to you all this morning. Great to see you. We had a great message start last week, didn't we? The beginning of the new message series, Win-Win. So that was great. Some takeaways from that. For me, the key scripture was great, Philippians 1:21, for to me to live is Christ and to die is gain. In other words, a kind of win-win situation, and a reminder that we take on too much fights sometimes. We need to just stand and stop fighting, don't we?
Are you looking at me like that?
Actually, I'm just looking around, just generally. Go on.
No, I'm just going to say that funny, the same sort of things you spoke to me, but I'll let you carry on first.
No, I was just going to say at the end there, Pastor Mike was, I think, was getting into a bit of a rap. The line was you do the faith in and let God do the fighting. It was kind of like a bit of a rap going there. You do the faith, then God do the fighting.
You look like one of them nodding dogs
okay.
In the back of
right,
the car.
Right, yeah, yeah. What did you take away?
Well, like you, the scripture in Philippians 1:21, and that the Amplified version really spoke to me. I mean, you could just feast on that for the whole week. For to me, to live is Christ. He's my source of joy and my reason to live. And to die is gain, for I will be with him in eternity.
Yeah, win-win.
I mean, that is an amazing scripture to just hold on to. And out of that, the other thing I kind of picked up as well was that death's not a position, it's a transition. And we need to remember that, because sometimes people don't always realise that truth when they've lost a loved one. And yeah, it really brings a lot of comfort. And the key for me in that message as well was, if we fight his battles, we'll lose. And if he fights our battles, we'll win. Because it's easier to take on the fight rather than take up the faith. And I was just reflecting on that. My grandmother was a Campbell. And so I come from like Celtic warrior stock. So for me, the natural is to fight. Yes. But I am developing my faith.
Very good. Picking up
my shield of faith.
Very good.
Yeah.
Very good. And Barney did a great Devo this week, didn't he? A reminder to stand. And if you haven't seen it, do get to the Facebook page. You can see the Devo. It's just headed Devo there. And the challenge was to us was, how are you standing? Are you leaning back? Are you laid out? Or are you going to stand with we're facing and considering this week, isn't it?
Yeah.
So people are joining us. So good morning to everyone. We've had photos. We've had Toby, Penny, Zach, Faith. So big welcome. One from Helen, one from Caroline there. People joining us. So it looks like Toby was doing some sort of workout. Did you see the arms going on?
Yeah, I think he's been doing that Joe Wicks as well.
Don't mention Joe Wicks.
No. Yes, our daughter Rachel was trying to get Paul to do the Joe Wicks, and that was hilarious. It's a whole new battle, isn't it?
It certainly
was. That's the battle of the bulge, not the battle.
Sounds like a wartime thing, that does. Battle of the Bulge, doesn't it? How are we doing? So welcome everyone, and just to say a sad day today because we'll be saying goodbye to someone, won't we?
Yeah.
Saying goodbye to Abina and to Tomi and to Christabel,
yeah,
which will be sad.
Gonna miss them.
Yeah, because I've had lots of little cuddles with Christabel, looking after her during the kids' time and that, and I've really appreciated that. She's been great to watch her growing up as well.
Yeah.
So we're going to miss you all as a family. Yeah, so we're going to say goodbye later on, aren't we?
Yeah, we are. But yeah, they're moving on to pastures new, both in their doctors, and they're developing their career and going for more training up north. So yeah, we really wish
pray
them
for blessing
well.
On them.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely. Good. How are we doing? Everyone's joining gradually. People saying hello on the message stream there. So we've got a few
morning
people.
Morning to CAD.
Yeah. Morning to Elaine.
To the kids. The kids, if any of them are watching, they've been doing their super moves as they normally
certainly
do.
Certainly have. Oh, we've got a trivia question this morning.
Uh-huh.
We thought we'd have some trivia questions. Okay, here's the trivia question. Answer at the end, but you better prompt me to say it just before the end. Okay, in what month and year did Pastors Mike and Lois start Destiny Church? So in what month and year did Pastors Mike and Lois start Destiny Church? And I'm afraid, Pastors Mike and Lois, you're banned from answering. So,
ooh, is there a prize?
Well, no, I'm not saying there's a prize, but it's just a feel-good factor.
Right, okay.
Okay, make sure I do that at the end. Okay. How are we doing?
Yeah, we're doing well. Still waiting for a few. I think the sunny weather, people are a bit...
It is sunny now. It wasn't sunny a bit earlier on, was it?
No, I didn't go for my walk today. I went out late last night, so I got a bit wet. So I thought I'd look forward to the walk this afternoon with everybody. Looking forward to meeting people down at the Western Pier at 4 o'clock.
And do remember, you can connect with Destiny Church. Just do send an email to welcome@destinyuk.com, and we will gladly send you a package of information, an email package of information about how to connect with Destiny, because there is loads of ways to connect through social media, through the website destinyuk.com. But if you send an email, welcome@destinyuk.com, we will gladly connect with you, and we look forward to doing that. So if you're someone that's just looking in today, why not send that email and connect with us?
Yeah, so really looking forward to another great message today. And remember, we can be winners before the fight, not just after it.
Uh-huh.
So let's see what new tips we're going to pick up this week and new revelations that Pastor Mike has got for us.
Oh, Caroline says there's no sun in Essex.
Oh, that's a shame.
Yeah,
now you're going up there.
I'm going up there. There better be some sun when I get there later on,
Caroline.
Yeah,
well, don't take it from Weston. We need it this afternoon. So have you got your praise pants on and your pencils sharpened?
Hope we have.
Have
we? Oh, the answer to that question, by the way, is December 1993.
Okay then, well,
December 1993.
Have a fantastic morning, everybody, and remember to share it on Facebook and have a watch party and post your photographs. Really looking forward to all that the Lord's got for us today.
We certainly are. So yeah, do remember, so many different ways to connect with Destiny Church, and shortly we're gonna have the countdown, and then we'll have the after that, we'll go straight into the worship. So great to see you with us this morning, isn't it?
Have a great day. Enjoy your morning.
God bless. Bye-bye.
Bye.
For many of you, it's in your front room, in your front lounge, maybe in your bedroom, maybe in your car. Maybe some of you are still working. Bless you guys. But we just want to give you a really warm welcome wherever you are tuning in from today. We are really going to lift up the name of Jesus. We have started an amazing, amazing series, which is all about win-win. And it's lifting up our risen Saviour, the King of Kings. So come on, church. Let's stand, push back that coffee table, and let's give him some praise this morning. Amen. Come on, let's raise the roof this morning.
Your love is broken every chain. I wouldn't have made it, but you came and saved me. I'm celebrating 'cause you've been so good to me.
Oh yes, you have, Lord.
With all I am, I'm gonna praise you now. Let everything within me praise you now. I said to you, bring heaven down. another level now. Let his praises be the greatest sound. As you do, he's bringing heaven now. The King of Kings is all around.
The song of the series, and I hope that it gets stuck in your head because it's such an encouragement, because it tells us that Christ is victorious, the battle belongs to him, and in him we have the victory because he has never ever lost a battle, and he never ever will.
Miracles when you move, such an easy thing for you to do. Your hand is moving right now. You are still showing up at the tomb of every Lazarus. Your voice is calling me out. And right now, I know you're able. Cause you never lost a battle. No, you never lost a battle. I know, you never will. you never lost a battle. No, you never lost a battle.
Lost a battle, and you never will. You can do anything. Oh Lord, this morning we just thank you for the truth, for the encouragement that's in those words, that you have never lost a battle, that you never will, that whatever we face today, whatever's going on in our lives, that Lord, you are in that battle and you have never lost a battle and you will not lose this one. Thank you, Lord, that all things are possible, that nothing is impossible with you, that you can do anything. Lord, we just thank you so much and we stand on that truth, on your word, on your promises today. And thank you so much for just being with us and meeting with us this morning. You know, church, sometimes in periods of uncertainty, it causes us to act in different ways than we normally would. And right now, there's been so much change, hasn't there? You may be facing uncertainty. You may particularly be facing uncertainty in your finances. Perhaps you've had a pay decrease. Perhaps you've been furloughed. Perhaps you're not sure about the security of your work. But you know, even when there is uncertainty, there is one thing that never changes, and that's God. And that he has never lost a battle, and he never will. You know, God is with us, he is for us, he is with you. He's already got great plans for you. But you know, sometimes when we face those things, we act from our human nature rather than our faith man. And God doesn't want us to shrink back in these times. He doesn't want us to be cautious or afraid. He wants us to still stand on his promises, to live out from his truth, to trust him. And so today, I want to encourage you to do that. I want to encourage you to give generously, because that's what God encourages us to do. That's his standard. He says, don't just be thinking about yourself. Give and it will come back to you. Trust me. Make sure your tithes and offerings are there, and I'll open the storehouses and I'll flood, overflow you with incredible blessing. But first, we need to do something. And so I want to encourage you today to step out, to make a pledge, to do something, to give, and to know that just like we know how to bless and encourage and give good gifts to our children, to our friends, to our family, to those people who matter to us, how much more does God care about us and want to do those things for us? So today, I want you to take your gift and I want you to sow it. And I want you to sow it in faith and draw a line in the sand and say, God, today I stand on your word. I stand on your promises. I know, Lord, that you always win the battles, that you are with me, that you will provide, that you will take care of me and my family, that as I sow this gift, I trust that you will return to us and meet our every need. And Lord, I'm going to sow this so that we as a church can continue to move forward, so that we can continue to reach out and bless those in our communities, so that we can continue to support the Philippines and all the work that's going on out there. So today, let's take a step of faith and stand on God's truth that all things are possible, that nothing is too difficult, that whatever your situation is, God has got this. He's in it, you are on the winning side, and he always fixes the battles. So come on, church. Click on that code on screen. It's so easy. That'll take you straight through to be able to give. You can go onto our website and find our giving page and go that way. You can transfer into the bank account. But today, just do something. Take a step and stand on God and trust him to do incredible things and to do exceedingly abundantly above anything that you could dare to hope, dream, or imagine, because that is who he is. That is his heart towards you.
Well, hello everyone. I'm here to give you a huge warm welcome to Destiny Church UK. If you've not connected to us before, welcome. If you want to find out more about us, please jump on our website at destinyuk.com. Hope you enjoy every minute of the experience. I will. Bye for now.
God has never, ever lost a battle. As believers, there's nothing that we lose in life when we know where it can be found. Even when we die, we don't lose our life, we gain eternity. In life, we've been gifted victory over death. If we fight his battles, we'll lose. If he fights our battles, we'll win. The key to winning the battle is all about and all down to how we stand. Because we're not just merely winners, we're more than conquerors. We're victors, not victims, even if and when we're victimized. We stand and watch God fighting for us, through us, in us, and over us. The enemy cannot win a fight that's been fixed. You can overcome anything if you let him fight for you and battle through you. Don't fight a battle that's not yours. Well, good morning, Destiny UK. Good evening, Destiny Philippines. Pastors Vaughn and Shiloh, we are looking forward, by the way, to connecting live with Pastors Vaughn and Shiloh all the way from the Philippines at the end of this experience. So do not tune out. Stay tuned in. You do not want to miss that live interview all the way from the Philippines, wherever you are in the world. Welcome to our DFAM around the world. Welcome if you're new today. Welcome, welcome, welcome. It's great to have you connected with us. Would you let us know where you're tuning in from? Just put it in the comments or send an email to welcome@destinyuk.com and we will email you straight back with all the details of our social media channels and how you can stay updated with everything that we are doing. So it's so good to be with you. We are missing our local church so much. We have some plans afoot for some things we're going to do from next weekend. Just watch this space. Even though it's not coming back together yet, we're working towards that. But next weekend, we're going to add another dimension. So just stay tuned. I'm not saying anything today. We've got to make sure we can make it happen. So today, I want to continue our new message series, Win. Like I said last week, and we sang this morning, wasn't that a great new song? I so love that song. God never lost a battle. Everything he did and everything he does, he wins. Let me say that again. Everything he did and everything he does, he wins. So I want to share again another key thought for the series, which is this. If we fight his battles, we'll lose. If he fights our battles, we'll win. Let me say that again. If we fight his battles, we'll lose. If he fights our battles, we'll win. In fact, we'll win-win. That's so awesome. I love that truth. I love the encouragement that comes from that. And I also love our key scripture in Philippians 1 and verse 21 from the Message, where Paul says, alive, I'm Christ's messenger. Dead, I'm his bounty. Did many of you eat any bounties this week after I said about it last week? I put that suggestion in your mind. I know some people said to me, oh, now you've made me want to have a bounty. I know I wanted the plain chocolate bounty. I still haven't had one. I'm going to treat myself to one this week. But we are Christ's bounty. Life versus even more life, Paul says. I can't lose. Can I just say to you today, you can't lose. If you know God, you can't lose. That's not just a positive thought. That's a truth. You can't lose. So awesome. We are winners regardless. We never lose because we're on the winning side. But remember, like I shared last week, the key to winning the battle is all down to how we stand. I want to say that again because we're going to really work on this today. The key to winning the battle is all down to how we stand. What kind of stand do we need to take? We have to stand on truth in faith by prayer. Oh, let me say that again. We have to stand on truth in faith by prayer. Wow, that's such a great truth. Just like Jehoshaphat had to do. Look what he does when he shows us how to stand in 2 Chronicles 20 and verse 1. It says, sometime later, the Moabites and Ammonites, accompanied by the Meunites, joined forces to make war on Jehoshaphat. Jehoshaphat received this intelligence report. A huge force is on its way from beyond the Dead Sea to fight you. There's no time to waste. They're already at Hazazon Tamar, the oasis of En-Gedi. Now, I want to stop every couple of verses because there is so much meat on the bone today that we need to feast on the word. See, sometimes what really Jehoshaphat is showing us here and what God's showing us is sometimes all hell seems to break loose. Some of you know exactly what I'm talking about. You've had that this week. You've had that this month. You've had that this last 6 months, 4 months, however many months we've been in the lockdown. Feels like more than 4 months, but I know we're about 4 months. It feels like all hell is breaking loose. It feels like everything and everyone is against us. And it's in those times that we need to stand on the word. The word in Romans 8:31 that says, if God has determined to stand with us, tell me who then could ever stand against us? Oh, I love that. Come on, let me read that again. If God has determined to stand with us, tell me who then could ever stand against us? Love that. Because really what it's saying is when God is standing with us and working within us, nothing can withstand us. Let me say that again. When God is standing with us and working within us, nothing can withstand us. And I love the way the message puts it, because it says this, with God on our side like this, how can we lose? How can we lose? So it goes on to say in this story of Jehoshaphat, shaken. Now, why do I feel an overwhelming need to add but not stirred? It's not even verse 007. Shaken but not stirred, Jehoshaphat prayed. He went to God for help and ordered a nationwide fast. The country of Judah united. Now, even though I'm not going to talk about that, there is so much importance on that word united. The country united. We're not even just talking about the church united. We're saying the country united in seeking God's help. Now, we might not be able to get the country united, but listen, as a church, we can unite in the one purpose that we need to unite in, and that is seeking God's help. And they came from all the cities of Judah to pray to God. Wow, I love that. When Jehoshaphat was shaken, he stood firm and went seeking. He immediately prayed because that was the position of his faith that he knew to take when shaken. Look what it goes on to say in verse 5. Then Jehoshaphat took a position before the assembled people of Judah and Jerusalem at the temple of God in front of the new courtyard. And he said, O God, God of our ancestors, are you not God in heaven, above and ruler of all kingdoms below? I love that. Are you not God in heaven above and ruler of all kingdoms below? Wow. Firstly, he knew the place to go. And secondly, he knew the position to take. At the house of God in faith. So he knew he had to go to the house of God in faith. And just to clarify, he wasn't questioning God's position. He was affirming it. I think there's something so important that we need to learn here. When we're shaken, we need to affirm God, not question him. Oh, let me say that again. When we're shaken, we need to affirm God, not question him. Because he went on to say, you hold all power and might in your fist. No one stands a chance against you. I think that's such a great reminder today of the mighty, awesome strength and power of God. We are not dealing with another human being. We are dealing with almighty, all-powerful, all-knowing, all-present God. That makes a huge difference to our lives. We're not just talking about each other. We're talking about God, the Almighty One, who holds all power and might in his fist. So no one stands a chance against him. So right from the get-go, Jehoshaphat declares the victory and he decrees the winner. He states this, win, win. In fact, he continues, and this is so awesome, I love this scripture. He says, and didn't you make the natives of this land leave as you brought your people Israel in, turning it over permanently to your people Israel, the descendants of Abraham, your friend? They have lived here and built a holy house of worship to honor you, saying, when the worst happens, whether war or flood or disease or famine, and we take our place before this temple, we know you are personally present in this place and pray out our pain and trouble. We know you will listen and give victory. OMG. Wow, I love the truth from that scripture, because he says, when the worst happens, not if the worst happens, when the worst happens. Now, he's not talking negative, he's just being real. He's just being realistic. Stuff happens. Negative things happen, but we don't need to be negative when we're going through negative things. We can be positive. We can be the ones who are the encouragers, the inspirers, the innovators, like we were doing, talking about in the last series. We are the win-winners. So we need to encourage people. We need to remind people of the power of God. Now, this is important, and I've said it before. If there's nothing to battle, there's nothing to break through. Let me say that again. If there's nothing to battle, there's nothing to break through. To experience the best, we invariably have to encounter the worst. It's just a reality. But it's okay, because we win-win. We should not shy away from challenges, because if we want to break through, we've got to go through challenges. But we can go through our challenges knowing that we will break through, because we win-win. When the worst happens, he says, we take our place in your house, because we know that's where you're personally present in this place. How many people, when they get a challenge or two, run away from the house of God? They don't go to church. They leave it weeks and months because they don't want to face up to their challenge. And that's the enemy's number one ploy, to pull you away from the very place that you are meant to be, so you can take your position, not on your own, but with the family of God around you. Because look what's going to happen as they gather together in one place. He says, we go there to pray out our pain and trouble. I so love that. I think that just brings a whole new dimension to prayer. We don't just need to pray away our pain. We need to pray it out in the name of Jesus. What got in needs to get out. Let me say that again. What got in needs to get out in the name of Jesus. Come on, we speak it out to get it out. And to pray problems out, we have to have confidence in our God, that he will not only listen, but give us the victory. Jehoshaphat goes on to say, and now it's happened. Men from Ammon, Moab, and Mount Seir have shown up. You didn't let Israel, touched them when we got here at first. We detoured around them and didn't lay a hand on them. And now they've come to kick us out of the country you gave us. Oh dear God, won't you take care of them? We're helpless before this vandal horde ready to attack us. We don't know what to do, but we're looking to you. We don't know what to do, but we're looking to you. Now I want to just say something that's so important that we need to understand. He is not blaming God. He's confirming his position and affirming his prayer. Let me just point that out, because sometimes we can read these things and we can read the wrong thing. We can read that he's blaming. We can read that, you know, some of these Old Testament guys were laying the blame on God. No, here what he was doing was confirming the position. Wasn't it like this? And now it's like this? So God, we don't understand. If you had this purpose, why this is actually happening this way? Why are we against so much? If you are for us, if you enabled us to be in this place, if you gave us this place, then why are we up against so much opposition? You see, the one thing he says that really is impacting is, we don't know what to do, but we're looking to you. Wow, I love that. Because what he's essentially saying is, we don't know what to do, but we do know who does. And when we don't know what to do, we need to turn to the one who does. Let me say that again, because someone needs to hear that over here. When we don't know what to do, we need to turn to the one who does. By the way, I didn't say it at the beginning. I want to say it now because I kind of feel like some people need to hear this morning. Press your share button if you've not already done it. Start a watch party if you've not already done it, because there's some people that need to hear this again today. Let's hope they rewind a little bit. But let me just say it one more time, just in case, as you share now, someone's just jumping on. When we don't know what to do, we need to turn to the one who does. It says everyone in Judah was there, little children, wives, sons, all present and attentive to God. Then Jahaziel was moved by the Spirit of God to speak from the midst of the congregation. And he said, attention everyone, all of you from out of town, all of you from Jerusalem, and you, King Jehoshaphat, God's word. Don't be afraid. Don't pay any mind to this vandal horde. This is God's war, not yours. Let me say that again. This was his word from God. Don't be afraid. Don't pay any mind or attention to this vandal horde. This is God's war, not yours. I so love that, because they came together, and what happened when they came together? God spoke. I want to say something today, because right now, I know for the foreseeable future, although things are changing by the day, we cannot come physically together right now, but we can come together on a Sunday morning, and I just want to really encourage you to keep doing that. Keep joining in church when we do church on a Sunday morning at 11 o'clock. I know you can catch up later. I know if you're at work, you have to do that. But if you are not at work, you need to make church. Why? Because when we come together, what happens? When we pray, when we seek God, what happens? We get a word. We get a word in season, and it only takes one word to change our lives forever. Don't miss God's word by missing out on the experience. He went on to say, tomorrow you'll go after them. See, they're already on their way up the slopes of Ziz. What a great place to live. Where'd you live? Ziz. You'll meet them at the end of the ravine near the wilderness of Jeruel. You won't have to lift a hand in this battle. Just, listen, just stand firm, Judah and Jerusalem, and watch God's saving work for you take shape. Don't be afraid. Don't waver. March out boldly tomorrow. God is with you. Oh, I love that. Let me just read the last bit of that again. You won't have to lift a hand in this battle. Just stand firm and watch God's saving work for you take shape. Don't be afraid. Don't waver. March out boldly because God is with you. I want to go wow and wow and wow. Because what's it really saying? Don't flee your enemy. Face your enemy. The enemy is the one that's meant to be fleeing from you, not you fleeing from him. And we need to face our enemy and stand firm. When we stand firm, we'll see God's work take shape. Let me say that again. When we stand firm, we'll see God's work take shape. What's it really trying to say? Have faith. Don't fear. Be bold. Be strong. For the Lord your God is with you. Come on, we used to sing that all the time. Did we really know what we were singing? It was a nice cutesy melody. But really, it's got such powerful lyrics. Be bold. Really, the song, the melody should have been different. Be bold. We never did that. Be bold. Be strong. For the Lord your God is with you. And because he's with us and for us, nothing can stand against us. Wow, I'm going to leave it there because there is so much more meat to feast on, but we don't have the time. We'll leave it for another meal next week and we'll feast on it again. There's another great part to the story yet. And I just pray today that that has encouraged you, inspired you, uplifted you, given you hope, given you strength so that you can make it through another week and face your enemy head on. But before I finish, I want to just ask you again, what are you fighting today? Well, we know that you're fighting the enemy, but what are you fighting? What is it? Well, can I remind you again that you're not meant to be the one fighting? Let God do the fighting and you do the faith in. Take your stand. Remember, Jehoshaphat was told to stand firm, stand strong, stand true. Do not move, be immovable. Do not let up on God's word. What has God promised you? Then stand on those promises. Do not waver. Do not fear. Do not give up on God, because he will never give up on you. You know, the only person that meant to be giving up is the enemy. And if you stand firm long enough, I tell you what, he will be off, because he will not hang around if he knows that you're going to be strong and bold and you're going to stand and you're not going to move. Stand on that word that says that you're more than a conqueror and therefore it's always win-win. Let God fight for you. Let him battle through you. Let him work in you. And I tell you what, you'll come out the other side and you'll be giving praise to God. I know where the story's heading, and I know that praise was a big part of what's going to happen next. And we don't just praise when we come out of the battle, we praise going into it. But I don't want to give too much away of next week's message. But you need to be praising God now for the victory that's going to happen next. Thank God for what he's going to do, because it's a promise and he's never ever gone back on one promise. So why would he go back on yours? Why would he start going back on promises with you when he's never gone back on one promise ever to anybody? His promises still stand. Come on, stand on that today. Be strong and be bold and be courageous and do not fear. Stand firm, stand true, stand strong. Can I pray for you today? Maybe you've joined us and you don't know God, but you love the whole essence of the message. You love the hope that comes from it. You love the inspiration that comes from it. And the only reason that we can have hope and inspiration, the only reason that we can be genuinely encouraged, is because this is truth. God is truth. Everything else is lie. You know, everything that the enemy throws at us is a lie. So we need to stand on God's truth. And that's why it's resonating with you today, because this is truth. And God's truth always resonates with us in some way. So if it's resonated with you and you don't know God, which is the most important thing you could do today, I want to just introduce you to him right now. And I want to pray a prayer so that you can come to know him. By the way, he already knows you. He made you. He made you fantastically. He made you fearfully. And right now, it's your opportunity to thank him for all that he's done and all that he's going to do. Just pray these words and say, God, I just ask you into my life today. I love to hear the faith and the encouragement of this message, the hope of you, God, working in us and through us. And so today, I want to thank you for already knowing me, and I want to ask you to accept this reply to your invitation to get to know you. I want to give my life to you today. I want to ask you into my life today. I want to make you my Lord and my Savior, knowing that the power that raised Jesus from the dead can be living on the inside of me this very moment as I pray this prayer that's going to change my life forever. So I accept the invitation today, and I make you my Lord. I ask you to forgive me for everything I've got wrong, everything I've done in the past. But I thank you that you are not focused on that. You are focused on my future. And I thank you that my future is not only the focus, but you've already fixed the fight. So I'm going to win. As I look to the future is fixed. Because you fixed it that I win. So today I give my life to you in Jesus' name. Amen. If you prayed that prayer today, would you just let us know in the comments there, and we will connect with you, and we will try to help you in any way to find a church locally if you're not near us here. I know you can join us online, but you might want to just go and join a local church where you can be part of the family physically when we can all get back together. Maybe today you're challenged like I am, that, you know, I don't always make that stand. I don't always stand firm. I waver sometimes. Come on, we all do. I think Jehoshaphat in some ways was wavering, even though he got it right. I think there was a journey that he was on, and he wasn't questioning, but he was really confused as to what God was doing. So does that help you today? That you're not the only one confused. I'm not the only one confused. There are things that God has told us in our past about our future, and it seems to be like all hell is broken loose. And I guess we've got to a stage of understanding where we realize that if we are going to break through, we have to battle. But to remember, when we battle, the battle is the Lord's. So what we go through, we grow through. So today is an opportunity of growth. It's an opportunity to grow a little bit stronger. And right now, I want to pray for you. If you want to be prayed for, just say yes right now, wherever you are, and I will pray for you. Just say these words. Lord Jesus, I thank you for your grace and for your love and for your power, and that you are Almighty God, that you are the one that no one can stand against, because there is no power greater than you. And so I today stand on your word, that superpower is living on the inside of me. The power that raised Jesus from the dead is living on the inside of me. And therefore, nothing that comes against me will win, because you've already said I can win. So today, I pray, Father, that you would strengthen me, you would encourage me. Thank you for the word today. Thank you for the encouragement today. Thank you for the inspiration today. And I am going to face my enemy head on and stand firm, stand true, and stand strong in Jesus' name. Amen. Come on, let's hear a big amen. Oh, I'm so pleased for you today that you prayed that prayer, but would you let us know if you prayed it, because it just encourages me. I know some of our own church pray that every week, but you never let me know. So would you let me know why? It's not important numbers wise. I just want to see people that have heard God's word, applied God's word, and been encouraged by God's word, and responded to God's word, because then I know that what I'm doing here every week is helping people grow. So I'd be so encouraged by you encouraging me. So we give praise to God for all that he's doing. He is building his church in this season, and we believe that there's going to be breakthrough very soon with vaccines, and we'll be able to get back together, and it's going to be such an amazing time. I tell you what, the enemy has made a big mistake with this virus. I tell you why, because when the church comes back together, see, he's not separated us, because nothing can separate us from the love of God. But I tell you something, when we come back together, he has underestimated the response that's going to happen. I tell you what, there's going to be an almighty amount of praise when we come together, and we are going to do such damage to the kingdom of hell. We are going to damage hell. We are going to damage every demon and demonic spirit in the name of Jesus when we come together. Watch out, devil. You have played the wrong card. You have made a big mistake in Jesus' name. We are going to stand strong. We're going to be healthy. We're going to be breaking through in every arena and area of life. In fact, let me tell you, devil, the only thing that's happened throughout this season, whatever you've done, however bad we've been with the virus, I tell you what, all you've done is strengthen our faith. You've caused us to be stronger in the Lord and to be bolder in the Lord. So we are going to take territory, devil. You are not going to win, because we win every single time. So I tell you what, you might have tried to get in, but we're going to get you out in the name of Jesus. We are going to take territory. We are going to take land in Jesus' name. Can I hear an amen? I know that's almost like another message right there. Anyway, have a great week. Don't forget, stay tuned in for Pastors Von and Shiloh from the Philippines, directly straight after this last song. And what are we going to sing again? Well, we're going to sing that great declaration of praise that God never lost a battle. Come on, let's sing it together. Amen.
Miracles when you move, such an easy thing for you to do. Your head is moving right now. You are still showing up at the tomb of every Lazarus. Your voice is calling me out. Right now, I know you're able. Cause you never lost a battle. No, you never lost a battle. I know you never win. Everything's possible by the power of the Holy Ghost. You Jericho, my walls are all crashing down right now.
Well, hi everybody. Hopefully you can see us. I'm not sure that we can see Pastor Vaughn and Shiloh, but we'll try and put that right. I'm sure that they will appear any second now, hopefully. But hey, I hope that you enjoyed the experience this morning.
What a great morning.
It was a great morning. There's Pastor Vaughn. Great to have you with us. Oh, we can't hear Pastor Vaughn at the moment. And Pastor Shiloh.
And Pastor Shiloh.
Can you hear us? You
can. Okay, they can hear us.
We can't
us,
hear
but
you.
We can't
okay, we're just going to see if we can put that right.
How about this? How about this?
Whether you've got anything your end. Don't think it's this end, so.
How about this?
Sounds... You... No.
No, no. We're still lip reading.
All right, wait.
Is it there? Okay. Well, we'll carry on talking for a second. And what a great morning. And really good response to the message and to the new song as well. I mean, just
powerful song, wasn't it?
What a song.
Hello.
Yeah, the kind of song
Hello.
You need to get stuck in your head so that when you're facing something that
Hello.
Just keeps coming back to you every single time. That God's never lost a battle and he never will.
Right.
Hello.
Yeah. Brilliant. Hello.
Okay, so we're still trying to connect with Pastor Paul and Shiloh, so we can see them, and I'm sure you can see them, but we can't hear them.
Hello.
So maybe there's just a setting. Often it's just a setting.
Yeah. But while they're sorting that out, we have to say goodbye to somebody.
Oh yes, we do.
Which is really sad. We hate goodbyes, but we have had such a huge pleasure. An honour of being alongside Tomi and Obina and little Christabel for a few years now.
Yeah.
And if you're watching this morning, guys, we just want to send you all our love.
Yeah.
And God bless you as you move up country
Hello.
To a different style of life up there.
Yeah.
But to further your training, and we love you guys. We know that God is going to bless you hugely. I know God has big plans, and remember, we're praying you back because it's just for a season.
Absolutely.
So just stay in touch, because we want to stay in touch with you and see how God is blessing you. But we're going to miss you greatly, and I guess the next time we see Christabella, she's going to be like
a teenager. No,
it's not going to be that long. We're going to miss you greatly.
And actually, we learned today, didn't we, that prayer, united prayer,
mm-hmm.
works. So we're speaking
prayer,
that word over you.
Prayer changes things.
You're coming back. You're coming back.
You're coming back.
You're going to, there's going to be the great comeback
yes.
to Weston-super-Mare.
Absolutely.
It's going to be the best job you've ever been offered, and
yes.
you just will not be able to
yes.
resist.
Amen.
Well, I don't know, are we connected with Pastor Vaughn? Can we hear you
Hello.
Now?
Hello?
Nope,
Hello?
We can't hear Pastor Vaughn.
Hello?
Oh, we can't hear Pastor Vaughn.
Oh, no!
Can anybody else hear Pastor Vaughn?
Yes.
Hello?
You can.
Okay.
Okay, so...
All right, so what we'll do, we'll carry on as if we can hear Pastor Vaughn.
Yeah.
Which may be a little bit difficult.
Let
but we're
me just
double-check anyway.
Something here.
Because if everybody else can hear, then...
Okay.
That's fine.
Has that made any difference?
Hello?
No.
Hello?
No.
Hello?
Okay. All right.
Hello?
Well, Lois will carry on talking a minute, and I'm just going to try and see if I can change anything on ours, because maybe it's our connection.
Which is very strange, isn't it? But it's great to see you guys, and thank you for joining us. I know it's been a funny 24 hours this week. We've been trying to get the connection with you, but... it's not easy, is it, so far away, but it's so good to see you and looking so well and keeping well.
Yeah, we're doing good. Man.
And the church are doing well? They're keeping
well
too?
Yes.
Oh, that's fantastic. Awesome. Well, we want to ask you to let us know and let everybody else know of the work that's going on there, because life is very different in the Philippines. I understand that you've been able to get out and about and actually have some meetings and services.
Yeah.
Albeit maybe in a smaller context. But can you I'll wait until you finish speaking to then speak again, because obviously I can't hear what you're saying.
We're lip reading.
Let us know a little bit about the work that you're doing right now in the Philippines.
Okay. Okay, so it's hard if you cannot hear us, but it's okay as long as everyone can also hear us. But first, I would like to introduce ourselves first. My wife Shilome, and me, Pastor Von. So I want to share to you the work that we are doing here. We are involved in different kinds of ministries here in Philippines, and one of that is that we are taking care of children. We are teaching children here. We have been doing that for many years. Since we started the ministry, we have been doing that, and we actually have lots of photos for the mission that we did, especially the children ministries. And my wife and I, what we do is we are teaching children, and we are also feeding children. I'm just so glad to say, I'm just so happy to say that we have we have people in the church, and sometimes my wife and I, we personally sacrifice financially to be able to just feed the children. So as of now we are before this COVID problem, we were able to minister to hundreds of children. That's 268 children to be exact. And what we do is that we are teaching them. We have done a lot of work, teaching them, giving them what they need, providing their needs also, especially. We have a mission where we also give slippers to the children, shoes to the children, and we also give school supplies. So that's one of our mission too. That's 268 children that we teach before lockdown. But now that we have lockdown, we are limited. We can still teach children, but it's limited. And same with gathering in the church, church service, we are also limited in gathering people. We are only allowed to gather 50% of the people in the church. So I know for some cities too, here in our country, and they are also doing the same. And the second mission that we do is that we are also involved in the tribal mission. We are helping tribal people, where we are giving them, aside from ministering to them, aside from sharing to them the word of God, we are also giving, doing our best to give them what they need, especially the food. That's their basic needs. So we are going to the tribal village and give them rice, give them the food that they need, and also feed them, because that's from many years of doing this kind of mission, we have seen how effective it is to share to them the word of God, and providing their needs too. So that's what we are doing here. When we usually give free food to those people that we minister, and the third mission that we are doing is we are also doing crusades here, evangelism crusade. or in fact we have conducted crusades here in our city, in different villages. That's what we do. And we also have we are also training young people, because that my wife and I, it's really in our hearts to teach young people, not only by teaching them the word of God, but we are also training them to become a part of the ministry, to be a part of the music team.
Sure.
My wife and I, we met when we were on our teenage years. We met in the church, and my wife used to be she was the song leader, and I was playing the music. So we met there. So that's why we after we got married, we continue continue what we're doing. We are both playing in the music team, and also we are also teaching other young people to do the same. So
that's great.
Wow.
Yeah.
Well, yeah. We now have sound, so we can hear you, which is really good. We don't need to lip read anymore. And we see one of your children behind you.
Yeah, he just woke up, my son.
Ah, hello. Hi, yeah. So it's so good to hear, what you're doing.
Yeah.
Just tell people where you are in the Philippines, because I know that the Philippines is like a massive place and lots and lots of islands.
Yeah.
So just tell people where you are.
If I'm not mistaken, we have 7,000 islands here in the Philippines. Yeah, so
we're surrounded by waters.
We are surrounded by waters. We actually live near the beach.
So the back
That's
of
a great
our
place to live.
Yeah. 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 Well, we are located in Surigao City, and
yeah.
our city, it's easy to find our city on Google, because our city is a surfing capital of our country.
Ah.
Yeah, you know many foreign people are coming to just to surf, mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying, surf on the
yeah.
beach.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So
well, you know
we
something,
are...
I need to learn how to yeah. surf, so that when we come to you, I can come and surf. That would take a miracle, I think.
Yeah. And
you're going to have to teach us, Bon.
Well, there are three different regions here in our country. The first one is the Luzon part, the second is the Visayas part, and the third one is the Mindanao part. The Luzon part, it's the place where our president lives,
okay.
Like the White House, the palace.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
yeah. So, and we are living in the third one, the southern part. Yeah,
yeah,
we are in the southern part of our country.
Okay.
So
yeah,
but our country is our city is the safest city here in Philippines. As you can see on the news, many foreign people are coming here to visit, because there are many beautiful places here in our city here, and also many islands.
We are just a small city with one mall only. We have one mall. Yes.
Yeah.
We have one
mall. It's just a small city. but a very peaceful city. Yeah. That's why many foreign people are coming here. They are just walking around the city. Foreign people are just walking. You can see foreign people on the streets walking, and on restaurants. They're everywhere.
Yeah.
Unlike our previous city, our birthplace.
Mm-hmm.
Our birthplace. It's called Zamboanga City. It's a war zone city.
Okay.
Really?
And there are many Muslim people there.
Right.
There are many churches there are persecuted. So, and it's just different. But we are living in Surigao City.
Right.
It's just a small city here in Philippines.
Well, you mentioned something there that I want to pick up on, actually. And I know Lois wants to talk about the children's work with Shiloh in a minute. But you picked up on the fact that your birthplace, there is opposition and persecution. And we know from connecting with you for the last several weeks now that you've had persecution. You've had people...
Yeah.
Doing things and saying things about you and to you.
Just
share some of that with our church and those who are watching.
Yes, Pastor. It's just so sad because most of those people that are persecuting us are just neighbors. Just neighbors. And some of them are, they have many, what do you call this? They talk bad things about us. And some of them, and most of them, they get angry every time we have services. They get angry every time we have services. Because here
just explain to people what they've been doing, because some people won't know.
Those are the people like in Zamboanga City, they are the one who like to throw stones in your church, on the church roof. They are the one who do that, and some of them also they can confront you to just make you stop the church service.
And sometimes there was one time that we were having a service and then our neighbor burned something. Really, the smoke really went to inside the church, and we're all crying because it's painful to the eye.
Oh my goodness.
And we have children inside the church.
When we have church services, they do what they do is they burn like it's
plastic
or rubber outside the church, so the smoke gets inside the church while we have service. So that's what.
Well, we know a little bit about that here where we live, because we have neighbors here that are right now breaking the law and burning things that they shouldn't be burning. And we know from smoke that comes into our house and into our neighbors, it's horrible. So to have that when you're doing church must be really, really bad. So, I'm really sorry that you are going through that. And like I was sharing with you yesterday, we all go through persecution, but we go through it in different ways. So for you right now, you're experiencing those kind of things, which we're not experiencing, but equally, we have to deal with opposition as well. And sometimes that opposition can be things like, opposition from landowners, regarding property that we're trying to be interested in. Sometimes we don't even get to view the property because someone gets in the way. And so it's persecution in a totally different way, maybe to what you're dealing with, although I know that you're also dealing with persecution with the land that you've got and, some of the things that have been going on there. And so we're definitely with you in prayer on that, and we stand with you shoulder to shoulder, as I know you do with us, and we will break through. Like I was sharing, we win anyway. So God never loses a battle. So there is no way that you're going to lose. You will see the church built. You will see God break through. So be encouraged today.
Yeah.
I'm going to let Lois talk to Shiloh because I know that you want to do that.
Yeah,
so.
Yeah, and I just wanted to say, I just that, you know, May, those people, the very people that are throwing stones and rocks and lighting those fires, may they be the people that are on the front row of your church when you open the new building.
Looking
forward to that.
Arms raised.
Yes.
But Shio, I know you were speaking a little bit earlier and we didn't quite catch the first part of what you were saying because of the sound. So you may have already said this, so please stop me if you've already said this. But I know you've been feeding the children, you were talking about that. And the pictures are amazing. I must say, you don't just feed the children. The way you present the food is just beautiful. It makes it look so delicious and irresistible. And so I know the work there that you're doing with the children is just amazing. And not just the feeding program, but the teaching and the providing. So you're feeding the soul and the body, which is just so important. But so you're not able to gather as many children at the moment. But I wanted to just ask you, because I know you've already talked about your feeding program and the teaching of the children, but how can we best pray for the work you're doing with the children? What do you need the most?
At the moment, we cannot gather much of the children because of this pandemic situation, and children are not allowed to go outside. So 21 years old and below, they are inside the house, and the senior citizens. So 21 years old until 59, you are allowed to go outside to buy goods and to go to the market. But 21 below and the senior citizens are not allowed to go outside. So that means little children are included to that range of age, including the young people. So we cannot really gather more children. So the barangay or our administrator here in the community, they will allow us if we have a larger venue for the children, so that we can measure them 1 meter,
social distancing,
yeah, and full gloves and masks.
Okay.
So that's what they're requiring at this moment.
Okay.
Right. It's a very similar situation here. However, our children are allowed out, and they are encouraged actually to get out and have fresh air. So for a shortest period of time, we were literally locked down and we had to stay in our homes. So I can only imagine how difficult it is for those young children to have to stay in the home and not be able to meet with their friends and not be able to go outside.
You know, Pastor, if we are allowed to gather as many children as we want, if we can only follow the protocol, the guidelines,
right,
you know, especially the social distancing. But here in the church, since we have a small place only, we cannot do that here.
Yeah.
So we only gather children that can fit inside the church, and also as long as we can follow the guidelines, like the social distancing.
Sure.
And
we have the same problem.
Yes.
In that actually we don't have a building, so the buildings that we hire, you know, some of them are now not suitable because we need a bigger space. So that's one of the breakthroughs that you can pray for us, because we need to see a change. We need to see provision, but we also need to see favor from those that have buildings, especially, and this might be something that, you know, might be very different for you, but we have, as you can imagine, we have a lot of old church buildings in this country that date back, you know, many, many years ago that they were built. And a lot of those are empty, and they're empty right now. They're not being used. Often those buildings are occupied by older people. So right now, older people are not getting back together because they're in that vulnerable group, suggesting, you know, should not rush to get back together. And we're trying to say, well, hang on, while you've got your building, why can't we come and use that place and have, you know, because some of the buildings are big as well. I mean, you know, that they would be easily possible to socially distance and follow the rules, but
we just
need a breakthrough with that. So we have buildings available, but they're not available to us right now. So we're just really praying for breakthroughs right there. So we totally understand what you're dealing with.
Yeah,
you know, I just wanted to pray with you guys. And one of the things we loved about what you're doing with the building, we're really believing that building is going to carry on and be built.
Yes,
so we're standing with you, and we will do everything we can to sow into that and pray into that. But we love the fact that in those foundations you put those scriptures.
That.
And I think that is so powerful. That was so creative. Well done. That was such an innovation for me. I'd never seen anybody do that before, and I think that's so important.
And you know if we plan to bury those scriptures there.
That's great, we'll
bury it there. But all those scriptures we are planning to laminate those so that you know it will not get wet, and then bury them.
Great. Awesome. So they'll be there forever, which will
forever.
You know, standing on the word. Exactly what we were talking about today. So can we pray for you both right now, and then maybe you can pray for us after as well. That would be great. So Father, I thank you for Vaughn and Shiloh and their team and all that they're doing in the Philippines, Lord. What a great work they are doing. I pray you will bless them abundantly. I pray you will provide way beyond their needs. I pray that they would see provision way beyond their wildest dreams. Lord, I pray that even as we are praying over them right now, that the windows of heaven would open up to them. I pray that people watching right now would be moved to sow into this work. And Lord, I pray that we would be given the opportunity to sow even more into this work so that we can see your church built. And we pray against the opposition. We know that this opposition comes from one place and one person, and that is the devil. And today we've heard in the word that we don't just pray him away, we pray him out, because what he's got in, he needs to get out. So in Jesus' name, we speak over this church, and we speak to you, devil, and we say, get out in the name of Jesus. And we pray for these people that you've used and you've made vulnerable in their vulnerability. And we pray that they would come to faith. We pray that they would be saved in the name of Jesus. And like Lois prophesied this morning, that they would be sat on the front row of Destiny Church Philippines in these coming days, giving testimony to you, Jesus, that you broke through in their lives. Yeah. Oh, Lord, we pray for miracles one after another in the name of Jesus. And would you bless this family? Would you bless Vaughn? Would you bless Shiloh? Would you bless their children in Jesus' name? We speak the blessing over them in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Would you pray over us?
Father, in the name of Jesus, we your word says that you are with us, O Lord, and it says that you'll never leave us nor forsake us, O God. You are with us always, Lord. So we stand in your presence. We stand in your word, O God, and we receive all the blessings, O God, that you are, that is written in your word.
Yes.
We decree and declare every blessings that you have promised in the name of Jesus, and we come to we come just to lift your name, O God. Thank you for Destiny Church. Thank you for Pastor Mike and Pastor Lewis and all the Destiny Church board. We thank you, oh God. Bless them. Bless the ministry in UK, and protect them, oh God. sent them, Lord, your Holy Spirit, Lord, and we give you praise, oh God. We give you praise. We thank you, oh God. We lift your name on high, oh God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you so much. Thank you. Well, it's been great connecting with you. And we are so looking forward one day, and I believe it's going to be sooner rather than later,
mm-hmm. that Next we year. Actually
get to the Philippines.
Yes, we will be there.
And we see you face to face, that there will be no social distancing, nope. so we'll be able to give you hugs.
Yes.
And we will
we'll
be able
to surf.
And we'll learn how to surf. And we'll we'll look forward to maybe what we can do. We can come out and we can minister for you, and then we can have a little bit of a holiday on the beach. That sounds a good deal, hey? We'll definitely try and make that happen. I know we that we've got leaders and team lining up behind
us. They will
us.
Be coming out with us.
I'm looking at Sam. Sam's on another screen just above this screen right now.
She's
nodding her head.
Well.
So they're all on the list behind us saying, we want to come, we want to come. So you could have lots of Brits coming out.
Yeah, we're excited. We will include that in our prayers, Pastor. Yes. We are really looking forward to meeting you one day.
Absolutely.
All of you.
We will be out there.
We will definitely be there. We're speaking it out in the name of Jesus. So
Amen.
Thank
Amen.
You so much for taking the time.
Bless
we know
guys.
That it's evening time
much,
for you. In fact, what is it there? Probably 7:30.
It's still early. It's still early.
Yeah.
7:30. It's 7:37.
There we go. Oh yeah, I can't read my own screen. Anyway, thank you so much. We love you guys.
We love
bless you,
you
guys.
Love
have
you
a great week ahead.
Yeah. God bless you all.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.